Hi, how's it going? All right, I am Rand. I spend most of my professional life trying to make sense of data, time, space, machine intelligence, and streaming data systems. And the most confounding part is time. It's really fucking weird. Why is it weird? Well, we're going to get into that. We saw a little bit of it with Quentin. It's contextualized. It's always built upon how people are observing and dealing with the world. Historically, that's been a whole bunch of lunar or solar calendars or floods or tides or, you know, all of these various hybrid systems that people have used to represent the world. Some of them work better than others. If we look in the definition in the dictionary, you know, we'll see a tautological answer, like it's how we measure things in the clock, or observations about sequences and ordering, or comparing durations and events. We want to get a little bit less pedantic, a little bit more structured. We look to physics. We can say, okay, cool, space and time. We understand that special relativity says that the ordering of events can be dependent upon your place and velocity. Minkowski says that the manifold of space and time combined gives us a constrained light cone. We've got Feynman taking a pass at it with the direction of time and the decomposition of quantum effects and particles, all against this background of time with some things going backwards. It's kind of messed up. What does it happen when we take all of this together? We still come back to this really loose observational thing where we are just observing change in time and space. You've got observers and events separated in space and something happening in sequence. Okay, that's still pretty observational, so what? At the end of the day, that's a distributed systems problem. And we happen to know a lot about distributed systems and some of my favorite fallacies, like the network is reliable, which is bullshit. The topology doesn't change. Space is warped all the time. So what does that mean for us practically? So if you want to send an event from green to blue and you want to understand how long it took, you send a message. And how do you know it got there? Well, you send an acknowledgement. What if the message gets lost? What if the acknowledgement gets lost? Well, then you send another message or another ACK. But how do you know that those got there? So you have this infinite recursion into trying to confirm that you sent something along. Same thing happens with the speed of light. You can't measure the speed of light without going two directions because you need it to bounce back and come back to you. So if you have failure, if you have change in your substrate, if you have messing things up, you can no longer measure space and therefore time. This happens all the time as well with multiple parties in the system. So you've got these three bodies trying to interact with each other. How do you know the ordering? How do you know the causality? Did message A get there before message C? What if message C was sent before message B? How do you tie these things together? Happily, Leslie Lamport tied a lot of this together with vector clocks, or Lamport clocks, which is his canonical reasoning about happened before relationships, which gives us some notion of causality, but without failure detection. Vector clocks go a little bit further at the complexity of time and space and carrying a little bit more information with you. You can now denote independence as well as just causal violation and correct for things. It gets a little hairy, but this has real-world implications. So you've got GPS systems, you've got satellites, you've got telecommunication systems. These things have to have synchronized clocks over relativist, non-trivial distances, and they have to synchronize these things and account for drift and skew. Can you drive around the town without knowing these things? Not really. Take it to financial systems. When you have rapid-fire financial events that have causality across time and space, as a direct critical component. Time is of the essence, time is money, and it fails all the time. You can't really tell one thing from another. And even in your day-to-day lives, out of this higher realm, like you're playing games, you've got chat systems, you've got email, these things have to thread together in this causally consistent way. You're sequencing against a backdrop of time, and it's constantly in flux. You've got all of these systems trying to do rapid-fire math with each other. And time zones, don't even get me started about the nonsense of time zones. This shit's broken. It gets really complicated all the time, and this is a factor of all of our lives. You know, maybe the observational perspective was pretty nice. Maybe just looking at the sky and seeing when and where things fell during the vernal equinox was not so bad. Maybe watching the floods wasn't too hairy. Maybe actually having a really intuitive effect was calming, relaxing, slow down a little bit and not worry about your slide timing. Maybe we can have a balance between the casual and the causal. Maybe we can have a balance between, you know, complexity and precision. Maybe we can actually worry about how to make things work, but not stress out too much about it. Maybe we can actually take a moment and enjoy the moment and the scene and put away the clocks, put away the timers, put away the grid, put away the Taylorism that Quentin talked about, and enjoy things a little bit. And, you know, next time you think about time and ordering, just relax a little bit and enjoy the fact that it's all just mess in the void.